Okay, this video is going to be about factoring a second-degree polynomial, and we're going to use something called the AC method. So here's how it works. We're going to start out with this polynomial. I've got 15x squared plus 19x plus 6. It's a second-degree polynomial because I've got an x squared, and my first coefficient is greater than 1. Let's see what else I know. My signs are all positive. That'll come in handy later on. I might be able to factor out a common factor, but it looks like I can't actually. So in other words, I can't just factor some single number out of this or an x out of it to make the whole polynomial simpler. So what I'm going to do is use something called the AC method. And here's what it is. We take the first coefficient of 15, and we think of that as a. Think of the second coefficient, 19, as b. And the third coefficient is going to be c. We're going to multiply a times c. In other words, we're multiplying 15 times 6. So 15 times 6, and that gives me 90. And I also want to write down what the b coefficient is. That's 19. Now, what I'm going to do is find factors of 90, pairs of two numbers that, when I add them together, will give me 19. Now, because 90 was positive, it was 15 times 6, I know that I want either two positive numbers or two negative numbers. And since 19 is positive, I want two positive numbers. Okay, so let's see what I can do. Starting with 1, I could think of 90 as 1 times 90. But 1 times 90 adds up to 91, and that's not going to help. 90 is even, so I could divide it by 2. I could have 2 times 45, but 2 plus 45 is only 47, which is way too big. I want 19. I could divide 90 by 3. So 3 times 30 is 90, and 3 plus 30 is 33. I'm getting closer to 19, but I've got a ways to go. I can't divide it by 4. I can divide it by 5. Any number that ends in a 0, you can divide by 5. So that's going to be 5 times 18, and 5 plus 18 is 23. I'm a lot closer to the 19. I can divide it by 6. Actually, that's what I had over here, 6 and 15. 6 and 15 is 21. Looks like I'm almost there. I can't divide it by 7. I can't divide it by 8. I can obviously divide it by 9. So that would be 9 times 10. And 9 plus 10 is 19. So this is the pair I want. That's positive 10. And let's write that. Positive 9. And positive 10. Now, here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to go back to the original quadratic, the original second degree polynomial. I'm going to write the first term just as it was, 15x squared. I'm going to take this 19x and I'm going to break that down. Remember, 19 is 9 plus 10. So I'm going to break 19x down into 9x plus 10x. Okay, so I took the middle and I just broke it down into two parts that add up to what the middle term originally was, plus 6. Now I've got four terms. Now remember, we had polynomials before that had four terms, and we factored them by grouping. So that's what we're going to do here. I'm going to group the first two terms and the second two terms. By the way, it really wouldn't matter in a problem like this whether I'd written 9x and 10x or 10x and 9x. Either way would have worked. Okay, so let's factor this first part. I've got 15x squared plus 9x. I know I can factor an x out of them, and 15 and 9, I can divide them both by 3. So I can factor out a 3x. Let's see what I have inside my parentheses. 3 into 15 is 5. And x divided into x squared is x. 3 into 3 is, 3 into 9 is 3. And x divided into x would just give me a 1. Looking at the second term, I've got 10x plus 6. So I could they're both even. I could divide them both by 2. So let's factor out a 2. And that's going to give me 5x, that's 10x divided by 2, plus 6x divided by 2 is 3. Okay, so let me draw a line here so we know where the problem we're working on. So now I've got this this grouped and partially factored, and I've got 5x plus 3 and 5x plus 3, so I can factor out 5x plus 3. And that's going to leave me with my second factor of 3x plus 2. Now, if any of this process here was confusing, go back and review factoring by grouping, because that's what we just did. Okay, so this should be my factorization. Let's multiply this out and make sure we can get back to the original problem. So 5x times 3x is 15x squared. 5x times 2 is 10x. 3 times 3x is 9x. And 3 times 2 is 6. Combining the two middle terms, I'm going to get 15x squared plus 19x plus 6, which is, let's see, 15x squared plus 19x plus 6 is the same thing. Here I am. The same thing I began with. So this factorization will check. I'm going to do another video with another one of these. It's going to be too long to fit into this video. This is a kind of a long and tedious process, and it can be somewhat confusing. So we'll do another video, and then please practice as many of these as you can, because it'll really pay off. You want to become kind of comfortable with them. Okay, see you soon.